Hi folks, how you doing? Well, welcome to another edition of How to Smoke a Pipe with Kel. Just how to smoke a pipe, not how to smoke a pipe with Kel. Anyway, this is a video I want to do for a long time. It's pretty simple. If you're want to be a pipe smoker and you don't own a pipe, first thing you need to buy, of course, is buy a pipe. And hopefully I've covered that pretty well about what kind of pipe you want to have for a basic pipe for, you know, your first pipe. But also you need a few of the things, and I suggest you pick these up on eBay. You can buy them off eBay when you're there, but really the best place to buy them is from your local tobacconist. Probably be cheaper that way, especially since you probably aren't sure if you can enjoy smoking a pipe at first, so why put a lot of money into gear you know you don't need. First thing, you need some kind of fire, okay? Like a lighter. I like this lighter quite a bit. It's a Conant 2 by Calibri, but it's like $50, and I don't recommend you spend $50 on a lighter, you know, before you even know if you're gonna like smoking a pipe. I like it because it has an angled head on it, but they make Bic lighters for pipe smoking. I don't know if they're really the Bic brand, but they're like a Bic lighter that also have an angled head, and those would be really great for a first lighter. You can usually pick them up at pipe smoking stores or tobacco shops. That'd be good. But you can also use wooden matches. Now, you have little ones like this, which if I use matches, is generally what I use these days. You can also use your general big kitchen matches, like that. Those work too. Now, I gotta be honest with you, I prefer butane over matches, because I can actually taste the flavor of the wooden match as I light my pipe. And with an angled head lighter like this, like in a small flame, I can really carefully be careful about burning the bowl. It doesn't make my pipe look old and all worn out. So I don't like wooden matches as much as I like butane, but anyway. But you can use wooden matches. Wooden matches you can kind of control too, especially the small ones. I do think over the long run, though, butane's cheaper, quite frankly. Once you get your lighter, then you're just buying butane. You know, that's another conversation. So, some kind of fire to light your pipe with. Of course, you need pipe tobacco, and we've talked about that some too. You got your pipe, you got your pipe tobacco, and you got fire. Next thing you're going to need is a tamper. Here's a pipe tamper here. I think these are made in Czechoslovakia, at least they were, they are now. This one actually is an old one from like the 50s or 60s. I bought like 10 of these on eBay for like $10. But they also make ones that are just, you know, they sell today at a tobacco shop for about $1 or $1.50. And I've had videos about my pipe tamper collection. But to be honest with you, and some of those are really fancy, to be honest with you, you don't need fancy pipe tampers. This is actually the one I use these days. It's not fancy. It's got a tamper on one end, it's got a spoon for, you know, cleaning your pipe out on the other, and it's got a little pick for, you know, aerating your pipe tobacco. That's all you really need. It's cheap. They're about $1.25. Don't spend a lot of money on a new one. And like I say, if I were to do it over again, this is probably all I'd ever own. They're fine. And if I lose this or it gets mugged up, I don't worry about it. My fancy ones, I'm kind of anal about. This does everything the fancy ones will do, and it doesn't cost anything. I can put it in my pocket, I can take it on the backpacking trip or something like that. Well, not going to be backpacking anytime soon. So, that's what you need, tamper. Maybe you're going to use it for tamping your tobacco down. We'll talk more about that later on, too. Then when you're done smoking your pipe, you need some kind of a pipe cleaner. And also these are handy for when you're actually smoking your pipe. Sometimes you get a little moisture in the pipe and it gurgles on you a little bit. You can stick them down your pipe like that and get that moisture out of there. That's good too. I prefer these ones for cleaning my pipe afterwards. They're Longs, fluffy pipe cleaners. These really get the moisture out of your pipe. That's what I prefer. And that's about it. You know, tobacco pipe, you know, pipe cleaners, some kind of fire. Some kind of tamper, and that's all pretty inexpensive. The pipe tamper's like $1 or $2, a little packet like that, you know. The tamper, you know, is $1 or $2 maybe, you know. And you know, if you buy a Bic lighter, and you can light a pipe with a regular Bic lighter. My problem with that is you kind of have to hold the lighter like this, and you can end up burning my hand very often. Plus, also the flame ends up burning the side of the bowl, which I don't like. I'm kind of anal about my bowl and keep my pipe looking good, so. If you can find those little Bic lighters that are angled, that's great. Or again, matches. Oops, I dropped things on the ground. Matches. That's about it. And again, pipe cleaners for during your smoke sometimes, but also definitely after your smoke. That's all it really is to it. Get yourself set up, you know, buy your pipe, buy some of those things. And you are ready to go, my friends. You're set to go. Well, that's it. Short and sweet. No, maybe not, probably not too short, but that's when I get done blabbering on about things three times in a row. Alrighty. I'll talk to you later. You guys have a good one now. Hope you're enjoying your life and enjoying your pipes. Because that is what it's all about.